Multiplying and dividing by zero, those are special cases, especially when you're dealing with fractions. First, let's just see what it means to multiply by zero. If you take 7 times 0, one way of thinking of multiplication is repeated addition, which means you're adding 7 zeros, which would be 0. So 7 times 0 is 0. If you take a negative number, multiply it by 0, it's also 0. We wouldn't say because there's one minus sign, the answer is negative. If you have a fraction times 0, it's 0. And if you multiply 0 times 0, you also get 0. So anytime you multiply any number by 0, the answer is 0. And it doesn't matter if the 0 is the first number in the multiplication, the second number in the multiplication, or anywhere in between. So you could have 3 times 9 times 0 times 6. The answer is still going to be 0. Or you might have negative 8 times 0 times negative 9. The answer is a 0. Anytime you have 0 anywhere in multiplication, the answer is 0. All right. Let's go on to dividing by 0. This is the hard part. Dividing by 0. So to really understand this, it might be helpful to think about what a definition of division. A divided by B equals C. Okay, if A equals B times C. Okay, so let's take an example. 6 divided by 2 is whatever number goes here. If 6 is 2 times whatever goes in the box. Okay, so in other words, let's say I'm trying to figure out 6 divided by 2. One way of thinking of this is it's the inverse of multiplication. So 2 times what will give you 6? It will be a 3, which means the answer in the box here would be 3. So A divided by B equals C, you could figure out the answer for C by figuring out what goes in here for C. But there's a little caveat. We have to say C must be unique. That means only one possible answer . Okay. So we're going to come back to this in a minute. So let's do 8 divided by 2. Just one more problem. It's whatever makes this equation true, which would be 4. So that's why 8 divided by 2 is 4. Now, what if I had 0 divided by 2. I want to know what would go in the box. Well, it says 0 would have to be 2 times whatever number goes in this box. And what would go in the box to make this true? 2 times what will give you 0? 0. So that means 0 divided by 2 is 2. Now in algebra, usually we don't use this division sign. The way we write 0 divided by 2 is this way. So 0 divided by 2 is 0. Okay, so let's do another one. Let's say 0 divided by 4. Alright, so of course that means the same thing as 0 divided by 4, right? And here's the fast way to get the answer. You think, well, what number here on the blank, what number will that be? So when I multiply it by 4, I'll get a 0. So that's how you think about it. What number times 4 equals 0? Oh, that's going to be 0 as well. So we got 0 divided by 2 is 0, and we just now also found 0 divided by 4 was 0. And in fact, any time the 0 is in the numerator and you're dividing it by some other number that's not 0, the answer is going to be 0. So what we have is 0 divided by some number, and note, a number that is not 0 So n is a number that is not 0. The answer will be 0. So 0 divided by any number that's not 0 is 0. What about when we have 0 divided by 0? It's a tricky one. Remember, that could be thought of as 0 divided by 0. So the question is, what could go in this blank? This number times 0 has to equal 0. Well, you might say, oh, 0, because 0 times 0, certainly that will equal 0. But somebody else could say, hey, what about 5? 5 times 0 will work. 8 times 0 will work. Any number will work. Any number could be right there. So, in other words, you could have 2, 3, negative 1/2, etc. Any of those numbers times 0 will always give you 0. So we have a little problem here. When you're taking 0 and divide it by 0, it's not a unique number. And that's very important. So 0 divided by 0 is undefined. That's exactly what we say. Anytime you have 0 divided by 0, the answer is undefined. All right, let's see. What about if we had some other number in the numerator, like 7 divided by 0? Okay, remember that means 7 divided by 0. What could go in the blank here? So then I would multiply it by 0, I get 7. Well, I know that 0 times anything is 7. So 0 times whatever's over here is going to be 0. It will never equal 7. So in this case, no number works. Previous example, any number works. So 7 divided by 0 is undefined as well. So any time you're dividing by 0, notice if 0 was in the denominator, it didn't matter if it was a 0 in the numerator or some other number, it ended up being undefined. So dividing any number by 0 is undefined. Right, let's do 6 quick problems. 0 divided by 7, what's that going to equal? Well, when the 0 is in the numerator, as long as there's not a 0 in the denominator, the answer is 0. And you could check by saying 0 times 7 equals 0 up here, right? The number over here times the denominator has to equal to the numerator. All right, what about 7 times 7 divided by 0? Well, 0 times what will equal 7? Nothing. Undefined. You have to write out the whole word undefined. There's no shortcut to that. 0 times 8. Oh, any number times 8, I mean, I'm sorry, any number times 0 is 0. 0 divided by 0. Anytime there's a 0 in the denominator, it's always undefined. So I should actually say this is undefined. And I want to clarify this one over here. I should just say it is undefined as opposed to it equals undefined. It is undefined. Right, how about negative 8 divided by 0? Again, anytime there's a 0 in the denominator, it's undefined. And the last one, 0 divided by negative 3, that's going to be 0. Right, so you have to remember, anytime there's a 0 in the denominator, it's automatically undefined. If there's a 0 in the numerator, it's 0, except for this one case where they're both zeros. If they're both zeros, it's undefined. Those are the rules for multiplying and dividing by 0.